The episode of Turn Up the Mic. I'm Chris. To my top is Roy.
What's up?
We're doing a IG live today, trying to try something different. How's your day going?
Good, man. This week went by pretty quick, but today went by slow. Saturday's always slow.
Yeah, that's what's up.
What about you?
Just a regular week, nothing special. Just chilling. I was thinking about with the virus and everything that's happening. I really think that NFL is not going to happen. The closer or the more places that are being affected, the more I think that it's just not going to happen.
The Hall of Fame game, that's the first step for them trying to say it's canceled.
Yeah.
But, I don't know. I don't want it to happen. I really want football to go. Like, for me, that's my sport. Like, I'd rather have basketball canceled than football. I think football is easier to contain. There's more people. But you can there's less games. There's less fan interaction because the stadiums are bigger. Like, their fans aren't really close to the players at all. And I think they can just test often. But just because there's one game a week, I think the players are safer because they can easily, like, if they have symptoms or anything, they can easily see development system in between games compared to having, like, back-to-backs and stuff.
That's one game a week per team, though, right?
Yeah, every team has one game per week.
But it's not one game a week. There's multiple games each week.
Yeah, but it's not like other teams interact with other teams. It's one game per week. Only two teams interact at a time.
And then how do you think that's going to work with all the traveling that's involved with that? I mean, NBA is going to Disney World. I don't see the NFL going to Disney World.
Yeah, I mean, NFL can't do that just because, NFL has, what, 20 times the players? I mean, an NBA team has 15 players. The NFL team has 55 players.
Yeah. So
that's not going to happen. But, we're still a long way away. I don't see the virus getting
better. We're like a couple months away. What are you talking about? We're ways away. We got like 2 months.
You never know with these things. They did say that they released, what was it? As of now, the games are going to go on. But the first 6 to 10 rows, it's either 6 or 10. First 6 to 10 rows will be empty.
Like, what stadium are they going to play in? Where are they going to go to play, though? You can't just travel across the country. I mean, if bars can't be open, I don't know if a stadium is going to be open.
I mean, they can play with no fans.
It's a big roster, too. Is there any coaches, refs, audience?
More tech. But like I said, what's on their side is that there are less games that are played. So it's easier for somebody to have, like, notice that they're getting sick in between games compared to the NBA.
Yeah. So do you think it's going to happen, yes or no?
Yeah, I think it's going to happen. I mean, it won't be till September, so I think it's going to happen.
I don't think it's going to happen. So if it doesn't happen, it'll be me saying that I predicted the right thing. If it does happen, we'll just say that we're both surprised.
Has Stephen A. Smith said that it's going to happen or not happening yet?
No, he doesn't have any, like, NFL insiders. He's a basketball guy. You got to think of Scheffner.
I'm just saying, because you usually say what he says, so I need to check.
I don't even know. Like, is he still, like, on the air right now? I thought he was on vacation. I don't follow analysis.
They don't do I thought they were doing it remotely. Who's doing it remotely? Skip and Bayless are doing it remotely, right? No, I mean, Skip and Shannon are doing Bayless.
I don't know. I haven't watched it in a while. But, yeah, I know they are. I think I watched it the other day.
Yeah. I don't know, I'm ready for football, man. I'm ready. This basketball thing, do you see they released the full schedule?
Yeah.
So
I
And it's
that's just for like that's their regular season though, right? Like their version of a regular season, like the last 8 games or whatever.
Yeah, the schedule they released are from July 30th to August 14th. That's it. That's for what they're calling it is the seeding game.
Yeah. So do you see any upsets on that?
Nah, and I think the NBA knows what they're trying to do. Because if you look at, I'm looking at the schedule now, all the broadcast games have teams that have the best playoff potential. Like if you look at the Friday games, Orlando and Brooklyn aren't televised. Phoenix and Washington aren't televised. Sacramento and Spurs aren't televised. So they're just focusing on the teams that have the best potential to be televised, to have the NBA. But so opening night, you have Utah versus New Orleans, Clippers versus Lakers. Who do you got on both teams? I'm going to take New Orleans in the first one, and I'm going to say Lakers in the second game.
What'd you say at the end?
Back.
Yeah.
I'm going to take New Orleans and the Lakers in the opening night. Who do you got?
You're taking Portland over the Lakers?
No, opening night is Clippers and Lakers. And then
I got Lakers.
Utah and Lakers. What about Utah and New
Orleans? I got Utah. I don't see them. I don't see New Orleans having an upset game or anything like that. And then we haven't seen Zion, so we don't know how big he might be.
You think he'll be in shape for 40 minutes?
Nah, especially since, like, nah, I don't think so. I don't know what's been open. He might have been doing Uber Eats, so he hasn't even been burning calories walking to the store. So it's not a good look for that. Yeah, everybody's dropping, like, videos of them working out, but I haven't seen no Zion. That's a cause for pause. So.
Pause for pause. Yeah. Hey, man, look at Luka. He wasn't working out till last week.
Didn't you say he had got the coronavirus? Or that was Jokic. That's why he got so small. No, it was Jokic.
That's why he...
Yeah, so I don't know. Luka might have gotten that stuff and got cured and didn't even need to take a test. So that's good he's back, though.
Our first game is a tough one. It's versus Houston, Dallas and Houston.
So, yeah, I would take Houston.
That's a good opening.
Who do you take?
I'm gonna take Houston that game.
Okay. What? But okay.
We'll see.
How far do you think Mavs are getting?
I hope I'm wrong. Let's have discussion when the seeds are actually in and we know who's playing who. It's better to do that. So, and then we'll make our predictions. I know their odds are 20-1 to win.
Oh, okay. Those are great odds.
Hey, for a team that I didn't expect this much from in his sophomore year, I'm really happy with how the years turned out. But
yeah.
What do you think of Adam Silva's article basically about? He was really going at players complaining. It's like, no matter what we do, there's going to be risk. What do you think about that? You think he's
perfect. I'm glad he said something because he's saying what everybody else is thinking. Like, I think some people are taking advantage of the whole we got the day off mentality, and they're not wanting to compete when that's what they're getting paid for, unless it's like for obvious reasons, like the virus or whatnot. But everything else, I don't see what the excuse is. Like, okay, you got a family. That's cool. But I don't know. That's just me.
I agree with you. I think it's nice of the NBA to give them the opportunity to opt out. Like, I didn't even know that was an option until I started seeing people do it.
Yeah.
But if I guess they're just not going to be paid or what, but all I know is anybody from, like, who opted out from the Lakers? Was it Bradley?
Yeah, it was just him. Dwight talked about it, but I see Dwight playing. He like legit said he's not showing up to work, so I think it's only him.
Do you think, say the Lakers win it all, do you think that Bradley should get a ring?
I wouldn't give him a ring. Like, he didn't do anything. Like, to contribute to them winning when it counts, I don't think so. Everybody can have a good game during, like, the regular season or whatnot, but in the playoffs, I mean, but if he's a part of the team, I know he's going to get one, like a bench player, but it's all good. I wouldn't give him a ring, though. He literally wasn't there.
I mean, you weren't there when it counted, right?
Right. So.
So, but this goes against your argument about Kawhi. Kawhi's not there as often in, because you say, oh, it doesn't matter, it's all season. Kawhi's not there throughout the season like you like him to be, but in the post.
But he's still there. He's
there. He doesn't miss a game.
And that doesn't really go against my argument, because Bradley – or what? Go ahead.
Yeah. No, because you said he shouldn't get a ring because, he was there during the regular season, but he wasn't there when he counted in the playoffs.
Okay, so how does that go against my argument? Kawhi is there when in the playoffs and in the regular season.
But you give so much crap for missing games in the regular season. It's just right now you're casual about it. It doesn't really matter.
What are you talking about? I'm saying anybody can perform well during the regular season, but when it counts, if you're not there, what's the point? He's not really putting in work.
I mean, you can argue he put in work to help get those wins, to help them get the seed, the first seed. What are they, first or second right now?
Yeah, because when I think of Lakers in the first seed, I think of Avery Bradley. Yeah, okay.
Hey, he has points. All right, so
yeah.
This week was a really big week for Kanye West, man. He planned everything to drop that day. So, like, when you woke up, you saw news that he struck a 10-year deal with Gap. And then he released the official video Starship. So, what do you think he's doing? Like, what else being that plan? Like, I'm really, really surprised that he struck a deal with Gap.
I guess I think he's capitalizing on his momentum. Like, he's doing the freaking foam runners. He put out those and they sold super quick. But I just think he's capitalizing.
And so, yeah. But I'm surprised the deal with Gap. I didn't expect – I expected other companies besides Gap before he would go with Gap.
Hold on.
But also it's weird that I'm surprised it wasn't like a partnership where he worked online, that it's an actual like 10-year contract. So I don't know much about like fashion contracts, but I didn't know they worked like that. Like, it's a 10-year contract.
As far as what?
That I'm sure I didn't know that contract could like that between like fashion designers, whatever, that it's a 10-year contract.
Oh, like, I guess. I don't know if that's normal. I think that.
Bro, you got that Ellie Wi-Fi. Yeah.
What?
So, what do you think of the Kitsy Ghost trailer?
Hold on. All right, what'd you say?
What'd you think of the Kitsy Ghost trailer?
The cartoon?
Yeah.
I thought it was okay. There wasn't any. They weren't talking or anything in there, right? I think we saw the same one.
The only one that said words was Kid Cudi. I don't even think that was him, though. I think it was a
character. Yeah. I heard a lot of them are using their real voice, though.
Yeah, me either, which I actually don't. I wouldn't expect them to either.
Yeah, that's a commitment. Like, they have to do a lot. But
did you like
them? It was cool. It reminded me of like an anime. They say that he's into anime, but I mean, it was just a snippet. So like, are you going to get like a full season? Are you getting like a mini documentary, like where you just drop like two episodes and call it season one, you know?
With Kanye West, I don't know, but Kid Cudi's in there, so I think, I don't know, I think we're going to get at least 5 to 10 episodes.
10 episodes, that's a lot of episodes. Do you know what it's dropping on? Is it going to be like Netflix or Kanye Flicks?
I don't know, man. Kanye likes dropping everything on his website.
Yeah, like 10 pairs of foam runners and then saying they sold out, but it's okay.
I don't know. I'm ready for it. I really, really hope that it's just not the trailer that's like that, but I hope they incorporate the music throughout the show like they did in the trailer.
It reminded me of like a video game intro a lot too. Like those old like Zeldas or like fantasy ones. Like I think it's Final Fantasy, but those like Fantasia ones, like the one that Disney had, the cartoon, like a movie, but still like a game version. It kind of gave me those vibes.
Yeah. But yeah, I'm definitely going to watch that. And Kanye, man, he's on a roll. His Gap deal, it made the actual Gap stock go up about 16%, which wasn't much because it was low already, but I did buy into it just because I expect a jump in. When there's actual previews of merchandise, and when the merchandise drop, that's when you're gonna see like the big jump in.
Yeah, I wonder what his price point's gonna be, because I know he only dropped like 10 foam runners, and those are $75. So I wonder if he's gonna like have regular prices, or is he gonna have like a little section in the Gap where you have to have like a key code. Or like the little app that unlocks it, because you know his stuff is hard to get to for no reason.
So, do you think this will hurt him in the long run, or help him? Because you know, like hype, a lot with hype has to do with availability. How hard is it to get? Because that creates hype. That creates hype for the next drop, because this drop was hard to get. So, do you think he's going to try to keep the same content, like you said? Or he struck a deal with Gap to make something more available for everybody. That it's like that kind of Kanye off-brand. Because it's not going to be Kanye, it's going to be Gap. So it's like you're getting Kanye, but you're not getting Kanye exactly.
Yeah, I think if he dropped it like a regular brand, it would solidify his brand more than just making it unreachable to get to. Because like Shaq, he has Shaqs in Walmart, and he's like a legit brand. Because they're year-round and they're always there. I think that would have a bigger impact on his brand than just, like, these hard-to-reach fashion lines that he puts out.
Okay. I was talking to a friend. I haven't been to Gap part of my kids were small, the baby Gap. Like, what is their price range? Do you know?
Know what?
Like the Gap. Like what is like? What are their prices? What's their price range? I haven't been there so long. I have no idea.
Yeah, so I would compare Gap's prices to like Express Men's, or like around Armani Exchange. I'd compare their price points to that a little more than what you'd find in like an H&M. I put their price points around that price, so it makes sense for them to be in there. Kind of like a Zara. I'm surprised he wasn't in Zara, actually, over the Gap.
Well, I think it depends on what he's trying to do, because if he wants more availability, there's more Gaps around.
Yeah.
So I know where there's more Gap stores before Zara stores.
Yeah. But I would definitely, either way, you can't really go wrong, because they're both, like, good brands or, like, established. But yeah, I am curious as to what type of product he's going to be putting out, because that would cause him to have to put some more thought into his clothing brand instead of just like shirts with holes or like 10 pairs of foam runners that nobody can buy, like myself.
I'm surprised that's the first pair of Kanye's I've seen you try to buy.
Yeah, I wasn't really blown away by his Yeezys or whatever. They were okay. But these foam runners, I like Crocs, and those are definitely like a new version of Crocs. I even put my little email in on his little website. And then as soon as I saw the little notification, I went there and they were all out. So that leads me to believe he put a very low amount out, which is messed up.
They sell out fast. Even like regular parachutes, regular shoes, man, they sell out quick. And it's funny because Kanye has that power, bro. Like, people talk so much shit when it first came out, like the pictures. They're like, who's buying these? No one's buying them, and it just sells out.
I mean, how many did he put out, though? Was it 10? It felt like 10. They went too quick to be 20. I don't understand. So it's probably the amount that he put out, too.
By the time you got that email, they were sold out.
Yeah, and I'm pretty quick with my emails. You see my notifications on my phone, they're like flawless. It's empty. So as soon as I saw that email, I went there and they were gone. So yeah, that don't make no sense. Maybe they'll be in Gap. Maybe we'll have foam runners in the Gap. Then that would be good. I'd cop them.
I would see. So he also did, and then like I said, he also did the spaceship actual official music video. It's never been officially released. You think that was more like to like, you know what? After all, was it 16 years? He's like, I did what I said I was going to do. Even though it was like 5, 8 years ago, he was going through a lot of shit with like the culture and with like fans and all that. And I'm pretty sure he put this music, because this music video is basically like, I did what I set out to do. It doesn't matter like how he got here.
Man, he's trying to be Beyonce so bad. Like, whatever he puts out, everybody's like eating up. Like, okay, he put out an old video. He's just late. I'm sorry.
I love the. Did you see at the end of the video what it said?
No, I watched a little bit of it and I was like, this video grainy. I don't know if this is the right one. So I cut it off.
16 years or 15 years ago. Like,
okay, so it's the right one.
But the end of the video said something like, there's no credits. It's like video cuts not done, not complete. Or video edits weren't complete or something at the end of the video. Like 15 years, that? Okay.
Have you noticed that all of Kanye West's stuff never seems to be like finished? It's always like incomplete products. Like he puts out shirts, they got holes in them. Like, is that like what are we doing?
He started that trend, bro. Leave him alone. He started that.
Nobody's saying he didn't. Have you seen his website? I guess he was trying to reimagine like the clothing brand experience online.
There's KanyeWest.com and like DZShop.com. But yeah, but I mean, I like his website's real simple. And then I know you're a fan of simple. So, but as we were talking about earlier this week, would you agree that if you're somebody that's looking for maybe that Kanye style, but don't want that price tag, but it's still higher end, you think Keith is a good option? I do. And you can find a lot of like plain, simple t-shirts that are high quality on Keith.
I'm not into like $30 t-shirts though. Like, it's a t-shirt. I don't really, it don't have to be like, if it's not super thin, then I'm good. I don't need a Kanye West t-shirt just to be like, I got a Kanye West t-shirt, you know?
Bro, leave me alone. You know how I am a Kanye. Leave me alone.
Yeah, I guess. And then there's some more music that dropped too. You had the Black. He dropped that EP. It's 60s Hot. Yeah.
What'd you think about it? I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed it. It was better than what's it called? East Atlanta Lovers or
Yeah.
That's the East Atlanta Love Letter. I was really disappointed in that album. Really like this. Like, I wish it was a full project. I really liked the direction of it. I felt like he showed that he was more versatile. So it brought me back to more of Free Black. Like, there was more things I liked on Free Black compared to East Atlanta. And I liked it a lot. It shows me that I'm ready for the next album, for the next EP or whatever he does. You?
Wasn't it really diverse, though? Like, did he really show something you didn't know he could do?
He didn't, but that's because of a lot of features and a lot of collaborations he did with other artists. But if you go back to, like, East Atlanta Love Letter, that was really, to me, one-dimensional and simple.
No.
So this had more diversity to it, and I liked it. I liked the beats on it. I listened to it twice without even knowing. I'm like, hey, I heard this lyric before, and then I'm like, oh, it was only 18 minutes. So
yeah,
I went through it two times without knowing it. But yeah, it makes me kind of back on that, you know, on that train and ready for his next album, because I was really disappointed in the last one.
I think Free Black is still my favorite project from him. Everything else seems to be like just repetitive. This one wasn't really that different for me. I liked it, but I don't think I'm going to be listening to a lot of the songs again, unless it's in like a shuffle or somebody's playlist. But I mean, I wasn't blown away.
No, I wasn't blown away. I think I expected what he did the last album, and he just kind of changed it up, and I liked it. Elephant in the Room is probably my favorite. ATL Freestyle was good. But like, no, I agree, like, Free Black, it's going to be hard to top that. It's one of those, like, that's one of those where their first album might be their best album.
Yeah. I mean, I can see him still putting out music, but he's starting to become, like, similar to Miguel, but in a sense that I don't really like his music like Miguel, but it's repetitive like Miguel. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I agree. And the thing is, it's what's bad with that is that a lot of fans just accept it. And basically, like, when you listen to Miguel, you know what you're going to listen to, right?
Yeah.
Even when you drop an album, you don't expect something new. You just expect new lyrics. You know what I mean? So, yeah. And that's where Black's getting to, where people are expecting the same thing. They just want to, they go to him for that mood. They want to be in that mood. And they're just expecting new lyrics with the same style.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's okay. I'd listen to a project from him if he drops it, but, I mean, I'm not going to go out of my way to listen to Black. Plus, his music's kind of sad to me, so I really don't be in that mood.
I like it. But what do you think's better, the new EP or his last album, the East Atlanta?
I like this one more than that one. It had a little more happiness to it versus his other one, which I just felt sad. So, yeah. I put this one over that one.
I agree.
And then you got Swiss Beats. I don't know why he's going at Drake. He called him a pussy boy. Like, I was like, whoa.
I saw it. Like, I'm not a Drake fan. I'm not, okay. I'm a fan of Drake. I just don't hold him how other people hold him up high. But yeah, to me, you need a legitimate reason to go at Drake. You don't just go at Drake to go at Drake.
Like, I played, because he was on the video, I guess he was FaceTiming with Busta Rhymes, and they were talking about that single that Drake dropped. I guess it's like an old song. And they were talking about it, and then Swiss Beat seemed to be upset, but I played it a few times, and I still don't know why he was upset. I don't know what the beef is between them. Like, he gave you Fancy, Swiss, you better shut up. Like, what's your issue?
I don't think Swish has, like they said,
he called him a pussy boy. What does that mean?
He don't have, like, you know, the clout to go after anybody. Like, he has some okay things, but he's been a background. He's been like a star background man his whole career.
Yeah. So I don't know where this energy is coming from, but apparently, I guess, I don't know, Drake may have called him, or his goons may have said hello, but he had came back on and he was like apologizing for that energy, and that's not what he wants to be known for and all this stuff. But I was like, oh, okay, somebody must have checked that energy. So he definitely changed his tune, but I just thought it was a little out of line, a little clout chasing, if you ask me.
There's a lot of that going on, man.
Yeah. And then, yeah, there's a lot of that going on. But, well, and then switching to sports before we wrap up, how do you feel about Dak signing his franchise tag? He changed his tune too. He's like, Corona, where's the papers?
I mean, he signed it. He waited till the last day that he can sign it.
So the last day, the plan.
No, the last day to sign the franchise tag was when he signed it.
Really?
Yeah, they have till the 15th to work out a new deal.
Oh, I got you.
But if he didn't sign it that day, he wouldn't basically got that money.
Yeah.
So
and the way that Corona is looking, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, why wouldn't you, man? I hate that people are out there like, why would he do that to himself? Blah, blah. But he's getting $31 million compared to what was he getting last year? Five, six, I don't know what he was getting last year. He wasn't getting anywhere close to $31 million.
Like, yeah, he definitely got a pay grade, pay increase.
Yeah, so, but they still have to the 15th to work out an actual deal.
Yeah.
But I like it. I would give him like that 33 to 35, what I've been saying. But I don't know. Like, it's just it feels like they've been on different sides the whole offseason. And I don't see it. And I feel like the Cowboys, someone's going to give in at the end. I feel like this is a good look for the Cowboys because they literally saw Dak give in to sign it.
Yeah.
So that tells them, you know what? If we wait it out again to the 15th,
yeah,
he might. And then do you see like a lot of that? Who was the analyst that was heated? Adam Scheffler?
Mm-hmm.
He was heated. Like I like the titles they use. That they're talking about that.
Yeah, it's very deceiving because they just disagree. It's not really heated.
But would you do you like that he signed it, or you think who's it a better move for, the Cowboys or Dak?
I think the Cowboys are obviously in a better move, like position, because they don't have to sign like a long term deal with them if they're not sure that he's the quarterback of the future. And then, like, come next season, then they can make the decision if they want to sign him. I think next season will be in Dak's play, because I think the second franchise will go up no matter what, even if the CBA money goes down. So I think he has more leverage next season than this season.
Yeah, like both sides aren't winning at the end. At the end of the day, if they don't work out a deal and they franchise tag him again, I think the second season goes up to like 36 or something.
Yeah,
like. Dude's gonna get paid. The only issue is that he's not getting any guaranteed money up front, and that's where all the issues happen.
Yeah. So I think he's in a. Yeah, and I mean it's more riskier to be on a franchise tag than a long term deal anyway. So he better play safe next year or this season.
That's if they play. I mean, I wonder what. I don't even know, man. Like, with everything going on, I don't even know there's going to be a season. I hope there is. I don't even know how payments work. You know, like, how much do they get paid? How much or what? Is it only guaranteed money that gets paid out if there's no season?
Yeah. That's going to suck. Because then he's still not going to get paid. But I guess the franchise will be guaranteed, right?
I don't know. I have to look more into it on how much, like, guaranteed as a franchise tag is.
Like, then it'll be like, damn, Jerry wins again. But we'll see.
Right. Man, like, we can go. You see, shout out to Vince Carter, man. He gave us over 20 years, bro.
Yeah, they keep bringing that up. Like, we all knew that was his last, like, three-pointer. But I guess it's for real now.
I think everyone was like, not sad, but remember what he said. He wanted, like, a farewell tour. He wanted that.
Yeah. Well, he got a goodbye.
he got a goodbye. He's, like, closed on you. Like.
Yeah, that door just slammed on him.
Who's retiring? Nah, we got the virus, bro.
Corona said. Helped. Yeah, that's wild.
Do you think
the only thing to stop Vince Carter was coronavirus? That's crazy.
Yeah, man, a long period. I think he is the greatest dunker.
You? Yeah.
He's known as some of the. Who?
Like, I think with the invention of different techniques and stuff, the greatest dunker can't really be the same person that used to do like off the backboard and straight up vertical dunk. Like eventually someone has to come along. I think the last dunk contest could easily be either or as better than Vince Carter. But he's definitely on the
Bro,
list if we're talking all time.
swung like he jumped over a 7-2 dude in a game. Come on.
And okay, who dunked over a 7-2 dude in the dunk contest? It's been done. Like, what are we doing?
He did it in a game. That's different.
Okay. Don't the people. Okay, and I gotta see the clip, but I'm pretty sure the guy didn't just stand there and let him dunk over him. He didn't dip a little
Yeah.
bit.
You think that's one of the greatest dunk highlights of all time at the Olympics? Vince Carter
Huh?
dunking over the dude. Man, where you at?
I think the last dunk contest was definitely pretty fire. But we should definitely do a list, like top five like dunkers of all time. 'Cause you can't put like right now because that's a short list. But I put like overall long term. That'd be a good
Mean,
list.
regardless of. I know our list might not match, but Vince Carter has to be on the top five no matter what.
Yeah. I put him on the all time, definitely. But I can't put him like obviously right now, even though he was playing right
So,
now.
judging off a dunker, are you solely going to go off like dunk contests or also what they've done in game?
What did you say?
Like, basing a dunker, are you going to go off like their special dunks during dunks
Am I
contest
going off
or
of
also
like
how like
in-game dunks?
yeah, also are you going to
Am I
put
going
that
off of
also
in-game
into
dunks or
consideration?
like dunk contests? What do you say?
Yeah, are you going to count both in game dunks and like dunk contests?
Nah, I'll just go dunk contests because in-game dunks are pretty like, what is it? It's either gonna be an alley hoop or just a straight vertical. Nobody's really doing tricks. I go dunk contests because it really shows like your athleticism and your creativity versus like an in-game dunk.
I think in-game dunks also can show how creative you can be in the moment.
I don't think so. What's the greatest
I
like
mean, you can
in-game dunk you've seen?
one of my favorite in-game dunks I seen was Blake Griffin when he was at the free throw line. He did a spin around the defender and then he threw it off the backboard and he dunked it.
Straight up dunk? Did he go between his legs or anything? Like that's not.
He threw it off the backboard and dunked it. Like, it passed
Yeah.
himself off the backboard.
That's like a
So,
vintage dunk, though. We all used to do that when we were little.
in the
You lower
game,
the
in the
goal.
game,
Yeah, you
in
lower
the
the
game,
goal, and then
out the game.
I did. I don't know. I had like a vertical. I had a 6-inch vertical. That's just me. But
We'll see.
yeah,
I'll send you the link.
we should definitely do a list, like top five all-time dunkers, and see who has who on there.
Yeah, Vince will be on everyone's list, but I'm surprised. I'm curious to see who else you got.
I put LeBron on there too.
LeBron's basic on dunks, man.
No, what's understood don't need to be explained. Like he's up there. He's a great basketball player, so he's an even better dunker.
I put Kobe above LeBron on dunking.
You're just saying that because Jordan liked him. So.
Because Jordan, what? No, because Kobe has better in-game dunks than LeBron.
Okay. LeBron has never lost a dunk contest. Let that sink in.
The only one I've known he did was the high school one.
Yeah. But anyway, before we
He
wrap
hasn't done
up,
one.
well, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like all the NBA dunk contests he's been in, he hasn't lost any. So, I mean, what does that tell you?
Okay. All right. I see the logic you're doing. I see what you're doing here.
Exactly. But anyway, before we wrap up, where can people check us out at?
YouTube, everywhere. Check us out on IG here on YouTube. Also, don't forget today is June 27th. Do yourself a favor and spin some DJ Screw.
Yeah. You know, I'm from Texas, but I'm glad you appreciate, like, the culture of DJ Screw and what he means to Houston and Texas.
I'm from talking about.
You said you're from Michigan. That's not Texas, but whatever. It's all good, though. But anyway, thanks for checking it out. Thanks for checking us out. Definitely subscribe to our YouTube, all that good stuff. Turn up the mic. We out.